Good morning all, I am welcoming you to the basic course on basic electrical engineering. So this basic electrical engineering course, I am just dividing into different modules so that the teaching will be easy. So I am dividing all the syllabus into different modules. So first one, module 1. So let us see what are the modules. So module 1, I am going to discuss about the DC circuits. So which we generally call as a network theory or network analysis and different names, where we are going to see starting from the charge, what is current, what is power, energy, Ohm's law, and series and parallel combination of the resistance, star delta connections, what are the different energy sources, what are the different terminologies used for the circuits, and then KCL, KVL, nodal analysis, mesh analysis, Maxwell's loop equations, superposition theorem, Thevenin's theorem, maximum power transfer theorem, Telegen's theorem, and all the theorems, all the things that are related to DC circuits, we are going to discuss in module number 1. So to make the things easy for you to search, so I am just naming my lectures as the module number I am representing with the first letter and then followed by the lecture number. Let us assume in module 1 I am teaching lecture number 1, it will be named as 101. So this 1 indicates the module 1, that means it is DC, and the remaining 2 digits indicates what is the lecture in that particular module. So then going to the second module, so module number 2, I am going to discuss about the AC circuits. So as part of the AC circuits, we are going to see what are the advantages of AC over DC, what are the disadvantages, why should we go for the AC. Again, in alternating current, there are different types. One is sinusoidal, rectangular, trapezoidal, different waveforms are possible. So why should we go for only sinusoidal waveform? What are the advantages? Then we see what is the mean value, average value, root mean square value, form factor, peak factors. Then after that, we go for the single phase circuits. That means resistive load, inductive load, capacitive load, and the combination of them. So after that, we go for the parallel circuits. And once those are over, we will discuss the series and parallel resonance. One, what are the applications of series parallel resonance? So once that is over, then we go for the three phase circuits. So we see the star and delta connections and what will be the power in the three phase circuits and how to measure the power in the three phase circuit, because the three phase circuit can be balanced or unbalanced. What is balanced circuit? What is unbalanced circuit? How to measure the power in the three phase circuits? Those things we are going to see in AC circuits. So this will be named as 2, followed by next 2 digits will indicate the lecture number. So coming to module number 3. So in module number 3, we are going to discuss digital electronics. So in digital electronics, we will see all the basics of digital electronics. What are the different number systems? What is flip-flops? What are the different basic gates, logic gates? And how to use an IC in the lab? And all those things we are going to see as part of digital electronics. This I am numbering with 3, so 301, 302, like that it will go. So after this we will see module number 5. In module number 5, we are going to discuss about analog electronics. So analog electronics, we are going to see the introduction to diodes, transistors, what is field effect transistor, and what is GNR diode, what is voltage regulator, and all those basic things we discuss as part of this. So it starts with 4, followed by the next 2 digits for lecture number. And then module number 6, we are going to discuss about different types of AC machines. So as part of the AC machines, we are going to discuss the basics of transformers, induction machines, synchronous machines, DC machines, etc. So that will be numbered as 5, followed by the next 2 digits. And then there is one more module, that is module, so I think I have numbered here wrongly, right? Module number 4 and module number 5. So module number 6. So module number 6, I am going to discuss about the laboratory experiments. So we are going to discuss about how to perform these experiments using the basic breadboard. So as part of this module, I am going to discuss about how to use the breadboard. Starting from that, what are the different components, how to do the color coding, how to identify the components, and how to perform the experiments and get the output. Along with this, if possible, we will try to see some whichever softwares are available for using the basic electrical engineering design. So those things we are going to discuss. So next class onwards, we are going to start module 1, DC circuits. In order to differentiate different modules, I am going to keep different color for the title page so that you can easily identify different modules. So if you have any queries or anything related to this, so you are always welcome to leave your comments in the comment section. So I will answer to your queries from there. So while making the comment there, if you can specify your email, I will send the specific material or anything you want. I can directly send to your mail also. So thank you. Thank you very much.